Okay, so this is my Seiko MEP meter. There are a couple of reasons I chose this watch. I wanted a good, fairly accurate quartz movement, but that was perpetual as well. So this one has got a perpetual calendar, so you don't have to set the calendar. It's got a rather unique movement. It's called the 8F56. That's on the back. I'll zoom in a little later and show that on the back. The 8F56 is claimed to be accurate within 15 to 20 seconds per year. Now you could end up paying even for a quartz. You do actually, believe it or not, get some mechanical movements which can be that accurate, but you will pay tens of thousands of dollars potentially for movements like that. But to even get a quartz movement that accurate, you can end up paying thousands of dollars. But Seiko did release a few of these movements in kind of cheaper watches, and I can't remember, this would have been between $100 and $200, or just over $200. Again, it's one of those details that I can dig out if you're interested for a later video. So it's a very unique movement. It also has a 24-hour hand. So that red hand over there can either give you an indication of AM or PM, or you can actually set it to display the hour of another time zone. So when I was in the States, like for instance, I would set that to South African time, because obviously I was communicating with people back here, and obviously you pick up your minutes from your main dial. So that's a fairly nice unique feature which I wanted. But the other very unique feature about this watch, which is why it's called the MAP meter, is this little thing over here. Now I sometimes tease my friends and say it's a portable pizza cutter, but basically what you can do, you screw back this little crown over here. And of course, there's no real practical use for this today. And you'll see it reveals this wheel on the side of the watch, which is serrated. And what you do, you could place it upside down on a normal map, or if you had the strap out the way. Now, this actually came with this, you'll have to excuse a strap. I put this cheapy, I wanted a rubber strap on this. It did come with a metal strap. I put this rubber strap on here, but you put this down on a map and you move it along, and can you see that outer dial moves? And basically you can then, if you've got a route on a map, you kind of follow the route like this with that wheel, that kind of outer serrated wheel, and that you then get your distance with this ring that's spinning round on the watch. And this one is metric, but you do, I say, you get the mile marker, which is the kind of in old money terms, so you can measure off miles as opposed to meters or kilometers. So that it certainly is a very, very unique feature. You can actually see on the side there the kilometer markings around that dial, which can move around. Certainly no use today in this age of electronic maps and GPS. But something that was fairly unique about the watch. So I liked it for that reason. The one thing I don't like about this watch is it has got a domed crystal. I'll see if you can see that over there. And that can distort the view. Unless you're looking at it square on, it sometimes gets a kind of hazy look. The watch is shaped nicely to cater for that dome, which is great, but it can be a little bit irritating in terms of getting a nice clear view of the face itself. But anyway, a fairly unique watch. I don't know any other manufacturer that's produced a watch like that. We'll come in a little closer to it. You can see it's already that scratch across the face. I say, although I enjoy my watches, I wear them. I don't wrap them up in cotton wool. I suppose maybe one day I might have a watch that I might wrap up in cotton wool, but you can see it's got a scratch across the face, which is why I wish, to date, I haven't owned. These are hardened mineral crystal, but invariably with me bashing around doing DIY or what have you, inevitably it's going to get scratched at some stage. Maybe one day I'll own a watch with a sapphire crystal glass or crystal in it. Let's just see how close we can get before the camera goes loopy. There you go. And let's just see if you can note the movement. I'll try and turn it up the right way. There you go. If you look carefully, you can see over there 8F56. Now, so that's a fairly unique movement. If you're into your watches and your movements, you can go look it up. As a quartz movement, that's a fairly unique movement, and that's the reason I have it. It's got this ISO. This watch has quite a few unique features to it.